Hardin Scott is not that terrible of a person. Would you date your boyfriend if he did all the things that Hardin did?
And
I'm not gonna give an intro, let's just get into this. Today, I am not only here to talk about my current obsession, a book series and movie franchise after by Anna Todd. I've read every single book, I own a copy of every book, and I have two copies of the first one, the original and the MTI, which yes, I annotated, and plan to do so with all the other MTIs if and when they get released. But I'm also here to ask, why does everyone hate it so much? If you don't already know what After is, first, what are you doing? And second, it tells the love story of two college students named Tessa and Hardin and their many, many, many trials and tribulations as a couple. I'm not going to give an overview of the entire book because if you're that interested, one, just read the books, support the franchise, and two, way too much stuff happens in the entire series for me to just gloss over. But long story short, our main character Tessa goes to college, meets this boy named Hardin, cheats on her boyfriend, starts dating Hardin, they fall in love, she loses her virginity to him, she gets cut up by her mom, she gets broken up with, she moves in with him, and then she discovers that he was only dating her to- Now that that's been established, here we go. Also, by the way, I'd like to thank Lovely Like Laura who introduced me to this series because now it's literally my favorite. So aside from being a cliche teen romance film like some people call it, let's debunk the real reasons people hate it, shall we? There are people who immediately hate Tessa and Hardin, and there are people like me who would catapult themselves into a pack of hungry wolves for them. The way some people look at After is like, started on Wattpad, must be terrible, used to be a fanfiction, automatic nonsense, cheating on your boyfriend, only in After, toxic relationship, I've never seen that anywhere before besides with Tessa and Hardin, my friends. First of all, yes, the series started out on Wattpad, but the fact that a book was originally written on a website for internet users to tell their own stories is not an automatic reason for it to be terrible. That being said, yes, stories on Wattpad could be terrible, but published stories could be terrible as well. At the end of the day, writers need to start somewhere, and the fact that Anna Todd started online doesn't mean that her writing is bad. Her story was read by millions of people and got published into a book series and later a movie franchise which won a People's Choice and a Teen Choice Awards, and sis literally walked the red carpet multiple times and toured the world because of a story she wrote online, but oh the horror, it must be bad anyway because it started on Wattpad, just throw the whole book away, that's the way people see it. I can understand why someone wouldn't want to read a book off of Wattpad because, from what I know, it's just a place for amateur writers but mostly teenage girls to dream up their own little perfect romance stories, and I guess because that's my cup of tea, it appeals to me. Personally, I love romance and live for cliches, like yes, kiss in the rain, follow her to the airport, make a giant grand gesture to win her back. I also live for enemies to lovers relationships, which is my favorite romance trope of all time. In regards to the movie at least, things like Tessa and Hardin holding hands under the table, or Hardin writing I love you on her back, or Tessa stuffing grapes into his mouth, those were all little details that make hopeless romantics like myself go, oh my gosh, that was adorable. Just like when Landon learned to dance for Jamie, or when Matt kept Jenna's dream house several years later, all these details like that are made to make people like me swoon, and obviously not everyone is going to be gushing over it. I feel like it just all depends on your preference. I like romance. I like cliche romance. Some people like horror. Some people like comedy. This is the type of stuff that appeals to the demographic of people who should read and watch this series. The fact that it was a fan fiction, I'm sure, is enough to make people not want to read it. Honestly, when I first heard about it, I immediately didn't want to read it as soon as the words "Styles fanfiction" were involved. But this story is not about Harry Styles. Hardin could literally have been any male celebrity, and Anna Todd chose Harry Styles because, I don't know, that's her favorite celebrity, I could not tell you. But it could have been any male celebrity in existence. All I know is that it's 2019 and this was a fan fiction several years ago, and oh my gosh, it is beyond past time to disassociate One Direction with this franchise, I swear! As fans of After, we are so past the point of this being about Harry Styles, and the only people who bring it up in relation to him are the people who use it as an insult or as an expression to say how bad they feel for Harry Styles. Meanwhile, if they feel so darn bad for him, why are they continuing to bring it up in the first place? None of the After fans are still linking Harry Styles with this book series. So why continue to drag him into it if you say that you feel so bad for him that he's a part of it in the first place? As an After fan, I am not going to sit here and try to convince you all that Tessa and Harden's relationship isn't toxic, because it is, and as readers, we all know this, and as characters, they know this too. It takes about 4 books for them to realize, but eventually they do. With this series, you can't just read the first book and base your entire opinion on the entire series. Even upon reading more than one book, you learn that Harden is a terrible person without a doubt. The movie, however, did not portray his awful personality, which I'll get into later, but he is a mean, rude, paranoid, obsessive, and over-the-top, angry, all-the-time boy. And I don't know what is with the romance haters, social justice warriors of the world or whatever, thinking that girls swoon over the fact that a guy has issues, because Tessa does not love Harden because he has issues. She loves him despite the fact that he has issues. And for anyone to say that she shouldn't love him because he is so troubled is like saying that people who have issues are incapable of being loved. And that, my friends, is just not a nice thing to say. Tessa Young is literally his angel and brings him joy and peace that he never knew he could even feel until her. So don't go around telling me that because he started out as a mean person, she shouldn't love him, because she is the whole reason he changes and becomes a better person in the end. Throughout the series, he did a number of horrible things, not only to her, but to other characters as well. But in regards to Tessa, we all know he saved her used condom, he showed his friends her bloody sheets, and made money off of her virginity. This was the book, by the way, not the movie. And all these things I know are wildly despicable, along with many other things that he does. But in the end, he finally changes, like he promised her he would, and the two live happily together. So I'm not saying that his love for her excuses any of his actions, because it doesn't. I am, however, saying that after rereading an unhealthy amount of romance novels, I've seen that Harden Scott falls right into the category of aggressive, controlling, possessive boyfriend with daddy issues and drinking problems. But in a way, I kind of feel bad for him. Again, like I said before, this doesn't excuse any of his actions, but my poor Harden was traumatized as a child and grew up without a dad, and had been lied to about his family for over 20 years. Throughout this series, I'm constantly thinking, wow, this boy needs therapy, which eventually he does get, but despite him being such a horrible person, it's not like he's horrible just for the fun of it. Harden is very possessive in the way that, like, for example, he tells Tessa who she can and cannot be friends with. And about that, here's what I have to say. When he tells Tessa she should not be friends with Trevor, that is not a reasonable argument, because Trevor didn't do anything wrong and Harden just didn't like him. In that scenario, it's not fair for Harden to tell Tessa she can't be friends with Trevor, because Trevor is a nice person and he just wants to be Tessa's friend. However, with characters such as Zed, sorry, but it made sense for Harden not to want Tessa to be friends with him. Zed was literally giving Harden nightmares and paranoia and driving him crazy without even trying. So it's just completely unfair for Tessa to even want to be friends with someone who is doing that to someone she's supposed to be in love with. What kind of girlfriend would want to be friends with someone who's driving her boyfriend insane? That was one argument that I understood, because Zed was just a terrible character, and I just, like, despite Harden being horrible in every way, shape, and form in that way, I felt so bad for him in regards to Zed. Sorry. The movie itself, I guess you could call bad. I know it wasn't the best movie in the world. Was the editing bad? Yes. Was there an unnecessary abundance of montages? See, was it extremely watered down from the books? Of course. Were there cringe lines? There were several, my friends. But as I always say, at least it's not Riverdale.
That means you haven't known the triumphs and defeats, the epic highs and lows of high school football.
We had Tessa, who was dumb enough to pick up shards of glass with her bare hands in the dark. Tessa, who sat there wondering where Harden was after literally reading Molly's message telling him where to meet her. Tessa, who literally went to the woods with a guy she met 5 minutes ago, like, sis, Ted Bundy would have snatched you up so fast. We also had this pouty and powder puff Harden who didn't swear once. Harden who told Tessa it's not her fault she cheated on her boyfriend. Harden who, oh my gosh, had some of the worst lines. Like, oh my gosh, some of his lines were just... At least it's not Riverdale.
It's the epic highs and lows of high school football.
The teacher who gave Harden's assignment to Tessa at the end, like, that was sweet, but ma'am, is that allowed? Zed, who spoke like 3 times, and Jace, don't even get me started on Jace. But even with this list of negative features, Harden and Tessa were so adorable, so that right there is your redeeming quality. But you can't even call the book and the film bad for the same reasons, because they were so different. They weren't a Walk to Remember book to film level different, but even so, the best way to describe this adaptation was like taking 50 Shades as a book and turning it into The Kissing Booth as a movie. And for that reason, locals are throwing this movie into the chick flick pile that films like Kissing Booth, To All the Boys, and The Perfect Date are in. Meanwhile, if you read the book... No.
Mouth travels down to my neck, then my chest. His tongue dips down and his hand massages one of my breasts. I feel the pressure building in my stomach and it is pure bliss. I mean, that's some hot reading.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really.
This unfortunately Disney channelized movie was cute, I can't deny, but even so, it wasn't the best movie ever, as I previously stated. Despite all this, it makes no sense to call the book and the movie horrible for the same reasons besides, like, cheating, because of how different they were. You can call the book out for being a toxic relationship. You can't say the same for the movie. You can call the book out for Harden being such a douchebag. You can't say the same thing for the movie. You can call the movie out for being a mushy cliche, but you can't do that for the book. You can call the movie out for being rushed and choppy and cringe and awkward, but you can't do that for the book. You gotta hit my girl Jenny Gage up for that one. I know so many people hate this story because it romanticizes abusive relationships, as everyone says. Enough people have said that to the point where I can't even try to deny it, because if like 600 people are saying it, it must be kind of true. But then again, 600 people think Trump's a good president, 600 people think cats are better than dogs, 600 people think Riverdale is a good show. I'm sorry, I just really like coming for Riverdale. Upon reading the first book, yes, it does have this constant cycle of arguments and sex and more arguments and more sex for darn near 100 chapters, but even if their relationship is bad, this book is addicting. Don't say that it's not, it's addicting. The entire series is addicting. I've never been more invested in a series, and I've read a lot of books. Out of all of them, this is the only series to make me feel such a wide range of emotions, from anger to happiness to crying to sobbing, and I mean sobbing. But I guess it's all up to interpretation, because I don't read this and say, OMG, constant arguing and tears and disagreements with my boyfriend, sign me up. As a reader, I personally recognize the negativity of their relationship, and if anything said, wow, this is not the kind of relationship I'd want to be in, but what's gonna happen next? Are they gonna work it out? Will they end up together? This series, I think, shows that if you're an idiot and make very poor, manipulative, impulse, angry decisions in your relationship and in your life, it's not going to work out, and you're going to be sad and alone. And if you take your time to better yourself and go to therapy or what have you, it may work out in the end. Obviously, these characters are fictional, but spoiler alert, if you haven't read the last book, we learn that the two of them were broken up for an extended period of time, but their love for one another never died, and they finally ended up happily. So while I understand that Hessa is initially toxic and not the type of relationship anyone should desire, the ending shows that change is possible if you're willing to give your all and become a better person for the one that you love. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Overall, I think this series is not for everyone, as everyone processes it in different ways, but Harden and Tessa will always be my favorite book couple, so sue me. All I can say is that the sequel comes out next year, I will be there opening weekend, and I cross the heck out of my fingers that it will be so much better than the first, and will actually capture the highs and lows
of high school football
of their relationship, instead of showing the happiness and gumdrops that the first film did. After We Collided 2020. Support the franchise. See it twice. Bring your friends. Buy some popcorn. Bye.